You're listening to Chinese Mandarin Cafe, Episode 3. What's your name? 你好 ,Welcome to Chinese Mandarin Cafe, a place where you can sit down and have a cup of coffee or tea. You can if you want. A place where we learn Mandarin Chinese in a fun and relaxing way. You can get the listen notes at ChineseMandarinCafe.com. I'm your host, Amy. Let's grab a cup of tea. Let's get started.Hello, 你好 ,welcome back to Chinese Mandarin Podcast. In this lesson, we are going to learn how to ask what's your name and how to answer that question. To say what's your name, we say 你叫什么你 it's the same 你 that we learned in our last lesson, which is you. 叫 means call, as in to be called or to call someone. 什么什么 means what?And I really like this word because it means what. You can ask a lot of what questions. So it's going to be really handy for conversations. What's your name in Chinese is literally you call what. Besides 你叫什么, you will also hear another sentence that goes 你叫什么名字? If you compare those two sentences, the only difference we have is at the end of the sentence we add 名字 to it.名字 actually means name. In our first way of saying what's your name, we really just say you call what. And the second way to ask what's your name is you call what name. You can use whichever you like. To answer this question, we will say 我叫我 means I. 叫 to call or to be called. So we say 我叫 I'm called or this is how you can call me.So for me, my answer will be 我叫 Amy. Here's a tip for questions that use what. Whenever you hear what questions in Chinese, such as you call what or what's your name, there's this two-step procedure that you can follow to make sure that your answer is always grammatically correct. Here are the steps. First, we need to locate the what word. In our case, our what is at the end. 你叫什么So it's at the end. Once you find where the what is, we're going to replace that with our answer. So this one is asking for our name, so we're going to put our name there. So now our sentence is 你叫 Amy, for example. And we are not done yet because we still need to change our pronoun to I. At the moment, we have it as you. So now we're going to change that to I, which is 我 Our final answer is 我叫 Amy. So whenever you see this kind of what questions, find the what and put our answer there. Then change the pronoun so that it's correct. And the second step is to change the pronoun if needed. Like in our case, what's your name? We're going to change that to I called and then name. To ask what's your name? You can say either 你叫什么 or 你叫什么名字And your answer is 我叫 followed by your name. Depends on what your name is, sometimes you might be able to translate your name directly into Chinese, especially if your names are popular. For example, the next four names are pretty common, and they are transliterations, so they are translated based on the sound. And I'm always curious to see if English speakers can understand the original name based on the Chinese sound. So I want you to listen to the name and take a guess.The first name we have is Anna. The English name for this one is Anna. What do you think? Do you think it's close to the English name? And the next one we have is Mike. Mike is Mike in English. Next, we have Lily. Lily is Lily in English. Lastly, we have 杰克杰克 might be one of the difficult ones among our four names. And 杰克 is Jack in English. What do you think? Do they sound similar to their English name or they are pretty far off? Let me know what you think in the comment section below. I would love to hear your thoughts. Now it's time for our review. I'm going to say the Chinese word once, followed by its English translation. 你 You 叫 Call or to be called 什么What? 你叫什么? What's your name? 名字 Name 你叫什么名字? What's your name?
我
I
叫
Call or to be called?
我叫
I am or I'm called?
我叫安娜
I am Anna or my name is Anna.
我叫麦克
I am Mike or my name is Mike. For this part, I'm going to say each word or phrase three times.
你你你叫叫叫什么什么什么你叫什么你叫什么你叫什么
名字名字名字
你叫什么名字你叫什么名字你叫什么名字我我我叫叫叫我叫我叫我叫我叫安娜我叫安娜我叫安娜我叫麦克我叫麦克我叫麦克
That's all for today's lesson. 下次见，再见。Hope you enjoyed today's episode. Remember, you can get the lesson notes at ChineseMandarinCafe.com. For more learning resources, remember to subscribe to the newsletter at ChineseMandarinCafe.com/newsletter. See you in the next lesson. 再见!